Hello, and welcome to this edition of School Notes. I'm Paul Rowe. It's that time when teachers, parents, and students are busy gearing up for the start of another school year. Hampton City Schools has been preparing all summer for students to return. Teachers receive training on how to incorporate iPads into classroom learning. Many were excited about the opportunity and can't wait to share with students what they learned.
The iPads are great in the classroom. I'm a foreign language teacher, and I like the iPads for students because they are able to use the iPads for real world experiences.
The city of Hampton provided funding for the iPad initiative. This shows the commitment of our city council to providing the best possible education to the children in Hampton.
I was okay in the classroom because I had my teacher there. When I would get home to do homework, I would cry. My mom was frustrated.
The teacher can look and see if the children are responding with the right answers. Also, if it's, you have somebody that's struggling with a certain subject, they can actually put step-by-step instructions on the iPad and the kids can see them right there at the desk.
There's all kinds of apps that they can create music with, that they can record sounds with. There's also an app that I have found where the kids could actually walk around the school and record their own sounds, tapping on the wall or tapping on any kind of with their feet or using a trash can, and then they can turn it into music, and it's their own creation that they can also share.
The iPads are going to be a great tool for the teachers because it's going to increase their collaboration between the students and the teacher, him or herself. And they'll also be able to free up some of their time. There are apps on here that students will be able to use that allow the teacher to manage their time in the classroom a little bit better. And it will also help them not change their teaching strategies, but enhance their teaching strategies.
Okay, I see where I'm
at. While we're talking about iPads, students are starting to receive their handheld devices for the start of the school year. The Information Technology Department, in conjunction with PEG TV, created this video to remind students how to care for their iPads. Take a look.
It's so exciting to get your own iPad to take home, but there are some things you need to realize when handling your device. First of all, the iPad is actually property of Hampton City Schools. You and your parents or guardian have signed a contract agreeing to Hampton City Schools' rules for using an iPad. You're responsible for your iPad, and you could have a big repair bill for any damage made to your device. Let's check in with Xavier about some of the biggest offenses students make with their electronic devices.
Uh-oh!
Whoa. I think it's safe to say that those are all obviously incorrect ways of using your iPad or computer. Let's take a look at some common mistakes that we make and show how we can make better decisions.
Don't use your iPad in the hallway while changing classes. It's too easy to bump into someone and you could send your iPad crashing to the ground. Instead, keep your iPad secure in your butt bag when you're not using it in other classes.
Okay.
Or carry it close to your body when you're not using a butt bag. Whether you're in the cafeteria at school or in the kitchen at home, keep food and drinks away from your electronic devices. We know accidents happen, but leave your device in your locker while you're at lunch, or just wait until after dinner to use your iPad. Please don't vandalize Hampton City Schools' electronic devices. Leave barcodes and any labels from the division on your device. Keep your iPad in its protective case. When you use a computer in the lab environment, don't pick off the keys on your keyboard and never pick up a laptop by the screen. Use two hands instead of a few fingers. Be respectful of all devices.
Now, let's talk about some common sense use of your iPads. Your tablets can do some pretty amazing things to help you learn. You can read books, write stories, make movies, and music all on one handheld device. Now, with all these pretty cool things on your tablets, you'll be very tempted to share stuff with your friends. But before I go, here are some things you shouldn't share or do on your electronic device.
don't share your password or login information. You wouldn't share your toothbrush with another student, would you? Don't share your tablet with anyone. You're responsible for its condition. Keep your selfies to yourself. Don't take pictures or videos of other students or adults without their permission.
As a reminder, tablets and laptops are property of Hampton City Schools. We want you to enjoy learning in a new way and to help inspire creativity by using the latest technology. Be respectful to your tablet, and you won't have to worry about your parents or guardian paying an expensive repair bill. iPads and laptops were not harmed in the making of this video. Stunt doubles were used. Do not try this at home, especially the part about breaking laptops and iPads. Just don't do it.
Teachers aren't the only ones learning during the summer. Students participated in a STREAM camp: science, technology, recreation, engineering, engaging academics, art, and math. Yes, that's a lot of learning in one camp. Students participated in various activities, and we caught up with students at Fort Monroe, where they tested kites they designed and created in class.
This week is actually our kite week. We're actually doing motion, energy, and aeronautics things. So the students are actually building kites and designing their own kites and then testing their theories of how they're going to fly. So we have two groups here. We have Bryan and Aberdeen Elementary Schools, which both operate the STREAM camp. And they're out here today really testing and getting a chance to see how their experiments are coming together.
It went pretty good. Mine was flying pretty high, and I got some good wind and some good breeze and stuff. So we pretty much just constructed it from basic household materials like straws and popsicle sticks.
We flew kites at this park, and it was pretty cool. It was pretty cool, and it was a good experience because I never really flew a kite before. It was fun to build, and it was just really cool flying with all my friends.
The Virginia Board of Education approved Hampton City Schools' application to establish an Architecture and Applied Arts Governor's STEM Academy at Kickitan High School. The academy will provide rigorous academic and technical STEM coursework. The Virginia Department of Education provides $5,000 startup grants to Board of Education-approved academies. Hampton City Schools' PEG TV department has been spending their summer making critical upgrades to its remote production truck and studios. Aging analog equipment is being replaced with digital equipment. While Verizon and Cox Cable broadcast PEG TV channels in standard definition, the upgrades will help PEG TV be ready when they switch to a high definition broadcast signal and produce better picture quality. However, many of PEG TV's programs are already recorded in HD, and you can view them in their highest quality on Hampton City Schools' YouTube page. The overhaul on the production truck should be completed in time for football season. This summer, there's been a nationwide move to create awareness for amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, or ALS. It's a progressive neurodegenerative disease that affects nerve cells in the brain and the spinal cord. You may know it better as the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge, where people nominate friends or family members to either donate $100 or dump a bucket of ice water on their heads and donate $10 to ALS. Teachers and staff from Armstrong School for the Arts stepped up and took the challenge. Several other schools and the division leadership team also participated. They picked a good day to get soaked. It was hot. We hope your school year gets off to a great start, whether you're teaching or learning or a little bit of both. Let's make it a great year at Hampton City Schools, where it's every child, every day, whatever it takes. We'll see you next time.